Hello, first grade students and families. We have been learning all about animals and habitats in Domain 8. Students did a great job creating dioramas at home of the habitats we've learned about in class. I love the creativity and research that went into these projects. The habitats that we explored and learned about in class are the Arctic tundra, the Arctic Ocean, the Sonoran Desert, the East African Savanna, temperate deciduous forest, tropical rainforest, freshwater and saltwater habitats. A habitat is a home to plants and animals. In order for plants and animals to survive, their habitat must provide food, water, and shelter. We learned that animals have adaptations to survive in their habitat. For example, the Arctic hare has a white, heavier coat in the winter, smaller ears so they are less exposed to the cold, and its back feet are wide and large so they can run fast in the snow. Now, the Arctic hare could not survive in the Sonoran Desert, but its relative, the desert cottontail, sure can. Using Venn diagrams, we were able to compare and contrast habitats. One thing that we found in common was that every habitat provides food, water, and shelter. We also learned about how the food chain works in habitats. We learned that if animals eat meat, they are carnivores. If they eat meat and plants, they are omnivores. And if they eat plants, they are herbivores. We also discussed the effect of what would happen if an animal or plant were taken out of the food chain cycle. After creating our own food chain using figurines, students wrote about the cycle of the food chain. Did you know that the bald eagle used to be endangered? Thanks to scientists, they discovered two factors that were decreasing the bald eagle's population: pesticide that was used by farmers and cutting down trees where eagles called home. Thanks to laws that were put into place, the bald eagle is no longer endangered. We discuss ways in which we can help our environment and protect animals. We have learned a lot of new vocabulary words and created posters to illustrate and write about their meanings. On our culminating activity day, students made predictions as to why animals have certain adaptations while reading the book Creature Features. Now, here are some fun ways to enhance your child's learning with this domain. Pack a picnic and spend the day at Cades Cove and Smoky Mountain National Park. Visit Ripley's Aquarium of the Smokies. Go to Bays Mountain Park and Planetarium. Have a movie night and watch one of these movies and discuss the animals and habitats in the movie. And as always, visit your local library to check out books related to this domain. Happy reading!